Jacqueline Moran is a young teenager from Southern California who learned to dance at the age of 2.
I've always loved it. I've always, since I was like 2 years old and up until now.
Her mom, Dina, also grew up with a love for dancing and always hoped she would pass that passion on to her daughter.
I, of course, always hoped that she would have the same love for it. I didn't pressure her, and sure enough, she loved to dance and never stopped.
Never stopped. Never stopped.
Over the years, dancing became more and more central to Jacqueline's life. And as she developed as a dancer, one of her instructors saw particular promise.
One. Where she had the beautiful long legs, the great feet, she had the musicality, the talent. And so she really had everything going for her, which is very exciting when you see that in a student.
Plié heels forward and tendu.
While Jacqueline danced nearly every day, one yearly tradition became especially important to her.
We annually do the Nutcracker, which is a really big production and really something special.
For this aspiring ballerina, learning new movements and techniques had always come easily. But early last year, things began to change. For the first time, Jacqueline struggled with her arabesque.
Lower this shoulder, can you? And get your leg up. Wait a minute, honey, your shoulder. I began to notice that when she stood straight, one of her shoulders could not go down. And no matter how I would try to correct it, she couldn't apply the correction, which was very unusual for Jacqueline.
My shoulders were crooked, my leg was low, and it was so frustrating. Yeah, it had always come with such ease, and suddenly I wasn't able to do it. I didn't understand what was going on.
Soon after her 13th birthday, Jacqueline got her answer. At her annual physical exam, the doctor checked Jacqueline's spine.
And the doctor had asked her to just bend over and touch her toes.
She said, oh, it looks like you have a little curve here, and I'm sure it's nothing. It's just my job to send you down and get x-rays just to check it out.
Jacqueline had scoliosis, a curvature of the spine, which was already forming a curve in her back. It was a condition that the doctor knew would only get worse, and he mentioned that Jacqueline might even need surgery.
I started crying because I was not preparing myself for anything, so it was completely overwhelming for me.
When I heard that, that for me was really sad news because I understood at that point Jacqueline was probably not going to be able to dance after the surgery.
I was like, oh my gosh, it's over. Everything just like went to the worst place in my mind, that I'd never be able to dance again.
Stunned but determined, Dina swung into action.
I told her, I said to her, you have every right to feel angry or scared or frustrated or mad, but we are going to fix this. We're going to get you a doctor who is the best that we can possibly find, and we're going to fix it.
Their search for the best of the best led them to Children's Hospital Los Angeles and Dr. David Skaggs, an orthopedic surgeon renowned for his expertise in treating children with spinal deformities.
So when I first met Jacqueline, she had 39 degrees of scoliosis, which is okay, you don't need surgery for that.
The first time I met Dr. Skaggs, I knew, oh my gosh, this is just, I'm gonna be in good hands here, because he was so warm and he made things very personal. And instead of just directly kind of telling me things and expecting me to listen, he'd ask me questions.
I think it's really important that everybody in the room, the child and the parents, realize that I work for the child. And I said to Jacqueline, this is your body. You're gonna probably have it your whole life. You know, I'm an expert in scoliosis. So I'll give you my advice, but you're gonna choose what you think is best for you. Nobody's gonna do surgery on you unless you want surgery.
Only 4 months after their initial meeting, Dr. Skaggs took a new set of x-rays, and the results confirmed their worst fears.
I was physically jolted when I saw the x-ray come up because I saw it without even knowing the degree, the curvature. I remember seeing it up on there, and it was just so pronounced. It was an S.
Her scoliosis progressed to 51 degrees, and that's the point where you really hit the point of no return, and her scoliosis is going to get worse for the rest of her life.
Surgery was scheduled immediately, and Jacqueline watched her dreams to dance in the Nutcracker slip away.
She was rehearsing for her wonderful
best part she'd ever had, on point in the Nutcracker, and then she finds out, no, you can't be in the Nutcracker, you're going in for surgery next week.
They were literally gonna fuse my spine and put two metal rods on either side, and just because I'm a dancer so I know the movements and the steps, and picturing myself with two rods in my spine, I just thought there's no way. There's no way I'll ever be able to do this again.
But Dr. Skaggs had other plans.
Sometimes, if you just do surgery on the upper curve and straighten that out, the lower curve will straighten out enough by itself. It won't be perfect, but she'll have movement.
He saw what was important to her, and it became important to him. It became the focus of his plan of action on how to help her as a doctor.
And once I heard that, I thought he was this genius. I was like, you've saved my life, because I would fix my problem, I would have a straight spine again, and I could still continue to dance.
The night before her spine surgery, Jacqueline took her last ballet class.
Normally we don't let the parents come in, but I waved her mother in and I said, I want you to videotape her doing this variation, because I really felt that it was the last time that her mother was ever going to see her daughter dance ballet. It was so sad, this beautiful dancer.
The next morning, Jacqueline goes into surgery, a procedure that will take 4 hours of painstaking work by Dr. Skaggs and his 9-person team. To ensure success, Dr. Skaggs uses a technique that he has pioneered at Children's Hospital Los Angeles, working with specialized surgical power tools to drill screws precisely into place.
When you put the screws into the vertebrae, if you're a few millimeters one way, you could hit the spinal cord and Jacqueline could be paralyzed, never dance again or never walk again. If you put the screw too far in another direction, it could hit a major blood vessel and she could literally bleed to death during surgery in a matter of minutes.
Everything goes perfectly and the team celebrates another success.
Jacqueline has two metal rods going up and down her spine, only in the top part of her spine. That's rock solid. That will never move again. Her spine is straight. She became about an inch taller, and hopefully it's the last spine surgery she'll ever have.
With two metal rods and 12 screws now holding her spine straight, Jacqueline heads to recovery. Upon waking, she makes it clear that she is determined to get out of treatment and into toe shoes.
And they all told me, well, don't be too eager. You need to listen to your body. You need to be careful not to rush things too much. But I was so determined to get up and walking again. I wanted to start dancing as soon as possible.
A few months later, Jacqueline tentatively returns to the ballet studio.
When Jacqueline first came back to class, she was very stiff. She had almost no movement in her spine. But she was also very determined.
I was so pleasantly surprised to find out that I wasn't in any pain doing any of the movements.
Jacqueline basically approached this as a trained athlete. She was a little bit weak, she was uncomfortable, but she got back to her normal dancing self very quickly by working hard.
I was dancing even better than I was dancing before I had the surgery and after I was finally straightened out again. It was amazing. It was like, I felt almost like all my life I've been dancing this way and this is how it should feel.
So what's most amazing is being able to give girls back their confidence, to let them feel like they're not deformed, they're not sick, they're okay. They stand up straight and tall, they go back to dance, they go back to sports. We're giving them back their normal life.
Only 1 year after surgery, Jacqueline has made a full recovery. And the holiday season brought her another gift. dancing in the Nutcracker.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 girls.
Being back in the Nutcracker this year just brings me so much joy to hear the music again, to be learning the steps again.
Right, stand up. You see danger ensue. You reach.
I'm happy as anything to find out a year later she got her spot back in the Nutcracker and she's dancing again.
And I'm so, so happy to be part of it again and with all my friends.
Clara, go. And Fritz, ladies be ready.
Sometimes when I watch Jacqueline dance, I literally have to fight back tears. Her comeback is just absolutely mind-boggling.
Children's Hospital made me feel like I was not just another patient, but someone significant and someone important. They changed my life, and I will always feel like I owe so much to them.